Hello everyone, now we have to derive the derivation for bandwidth. So what is the actual value of bandwidth when the examiner provides the value of resistance, inductance as well as capacitance, right? We know that what is the criteria to get the actual bandwidth, right? The current which is more than equal to maximum value of current by root 2. That is to get the condition, to get the bandwidth. So, after this first we have to take the margin value of that current, that is I is equals to I max by 2, which is equals to or greater than or equals to, means what? This is the minimum value, right? What is the maximum value? Current more than I max by root 2. So, by considering this equation we can get the bandwidth. So, from this I is equals to 1 by root 2 I max, right? So, what is the value of I? V by Z 1 by root 2. What is I max under resonance? Maximum value of current we can get V by R, right? From this V gets common, therefore Z is equals to root 2 R. This is very very important. This is the value of impedance at what? At half power frequency. This is the value of impedance at half power frequency only. We know that Z is equals to only R. This is the value of impedance at what? At resonant frequency. To avoid confusion, here I am providing the difference between these two and this two, right? So, Z is equals root 2 R. This is the impedance at half power frequency. This is the impedance at resonant frequency, right? Do not confuse at all. So, from this Z is equals to root 2 R. That is Z is equals to root 2 R we got. Z is equals to what? Square root of R square XL minus XC whole square, which is equals to root 2 R, right? Therefore, R square XL minus XC whole square into 2 R square, right? From this XL minus XC whole square is equals to R square. We can get XL minus XC is equals to plus R minus R. Finally, we got this, right? XL minus XC is equals to R. So, from this we can get two cases. Case 1, what is case 1? That is XL minus XC is equals to plus R. So, from this, that is this is lower cutoff frequency, this is higher cutoff frequency, right? This is resonant frequency. Now, it is assume XL minus XC, it is positive value. So, the region which is more than resonant frequency is nothing but what? XL more than XC value. Therefore, it should be considered as omega H into L minus 1 by omega h into c, right, which is equals to plus r. Therefore, omega h square into l c minus 1, which is equals to omega h into r c. So, from this we can get l c minus r c minus 1 is equals to 0. Therefore, L C minus sorry, omega square minus omega h into cc gets common, therefore we can get r by l minus 1 by lc is equals to 0. So we are having this equation. So from this you can get the value of, which is equals to what, minus b plus r minus b square minus 4ac by 2a. So from this we can get r by l, we can consider only plus value. Now r by l whole square plus r minus minus 4ac, already we have minus, so minus 4 by lc, right? This is the equation by 2a. What is the value of a? Is nothing but 2 only. So from this we can write r by 2l plus, it should be 1 by 2, so in the square root it should be 1 by 4, that is r by 2l whole square 1 by 4 into 4 by lc. Clear? So from this 4 4 gets common, we can get the upper cutoff frequency is nothing but r by 2l plus square root of r by 2l whole square plus 1 by lc. This is the upper cutoff frequency, that is higher half power frequency radians per second. Like that, from case 2, what is case 2? XL minus XC, which is equals to minus R, right? This is the region. XL minus XC means what? Lower cutoff frequency minus 1 by C, which is equals to minus R. From this omega square plus minus 1 is equals to 0. Therefore, plus r by l minus 1 by lc is equals to 0. Therefore, omega is equals to r by l plus r by whole square plus 4 by lc by 2, right? By 2. So from this radians per second is equals to what? Same, you can get r by 2l plus r by 2l whole square plus 1 by lc. This is the lower cutoff frequency radians per second. We all know that. What is the formula for bandwidth? We know that bandwidth upper cutoff frequency minus lower cutoff frequency, that is higher half power frequency minus lower half power frequency, that is bandwidth is equals to, this is the value, right? So r by 2l plus square root of r by 2l whole square plus 1 by lc, right? Like that, minus this value. So minus of minus plus r by 2l minus square root of r by 2l whole square plus 1 by lc. So from this, this term gets cancelled, therefore we can get bandwidth is equals to r by 2l plus, which is equals to 2 r by 2l. Therefore, bandwidth is equals to r by l, right? units are radians per second. In terms of frequency, in terms of hertz, that is r by 2 pi l, that is 2 pi f is equals to r by l. Therefore, from this f is equals to r by 2 pi l. This is the frequency in hertz, that is hertz. This is the formula for bandwidth, that is r by l, r by l. Simply, so this is the condition to get the satisfactory operation of bandwidth. From this we can consider only I is equals to I max by root 2. Therefore, we can get Z is equals to root 2 R. This is the impedance at half power frequency only. Okay, just kindly note this point. We all know that Z is equals to R at resonant frequency. So, from this Z equals to root 2 R, we can get this equation. From this we have plus R minus R. Therefore, case 1 is what? XL minus XC plus R. From this we can have upper cutoff frequency is what? Like this. From this, lower half power frequency is like this. So, from this we all know that bandwidth is what? Upper cutoff frequency minus lower cutoff frequency. Therefore, we are having the bandwidth as r by l radians per second or r by 2 pi l hertz. This is the derivation for bandwidth. Now, we have to derive the relation between resonant frequency and half power frequencies. Between resonant frequency and half power frequencies. Right, we know that upper cutoff frequency is what? R by 2 L plus square root of R by 2 L whole square plus 1 by LC. Right, like that lower cutoff frequency is what? Minus R by 2 L plus R by 2 L whole square plus 1 by L C. Clear? Then let us assume, let, or you can write here, assume A is equals to R by 2 L whole square plus 1 by L C and B is equals to R by 2 L, right? Like this, you can assume A is equals to R by 2 L whole square plus 1 by L C, B is equals to R by 2 L. Therefore, upper cutoff frequency is what? A plus B, right? From this A, B, sorry, this one A, this part is A, this part is B. A plus B and lower cutoff frequency is what? A minus B. Clear? Then here the point comes, that is what will happen if you multiply upper cutoff frequency and lower cutoff frequency, that is A plus B into A minus B, which is equals to what? A square minus B square, which is equals to, what is the value of A? This point, right? That is R by 2 L whole square plus 1 by L C. This is the value of A square minus, what is the value of B? This part, that is R by 2 L whole square, right? Therefore, this part gets cancelled. So, from this analysis, what we got, which is equals to what? 1 by L C. We all know that 1 by L C is nothing but what? 1 by root LC is nothing but formula for resonance frequency. But here we have what? 1 by LC. Therefore, we are having omega r square. From this, omega r is nothing but square root of multiplication of 2 half power frequencies. So, this is the relation between resonant frequency and 2 half power frequencies. That is, what is that? We got, resonant frequency is equals to multiplication of 2 half power frequencies. Means what? Resonant frequency is the geometric mean of 2 half power frequencies. Very important observation. What is resonant frequency if we have 2 half power frequencies? Simply we have to multiply both half power frequencies and simply square root of that content. We can get the resonant frequency is nothing but resonant frequency is the geometric mean of 2 half power frequencies. So, this is the relation between omega r and omega h and omega l. And now we have to get relation between quality factor and bandwidth. Now we have to get the relation between quality factor and bandwidth. We know that quality factor, which is equals to what? Under resonance, resonant frequency into L by R, or you can consider 1 by omega R R C. Here I am considering this part only. Therefore, from this, we all know this value. So, from this, quality factor is equals to omega r by, we can write r by l. We all know that since omega r is equals to 1 by root l c. We all know that bandwidth is equals to r by l. Then substitute this value into this. Therefore, quality factor is equals to bandwidth, That is resonant frequency by bandwidth. This is the formula for or relation between quality factor and bandwidth. That is, can have quality factor is equals to resonant frequency, that is you can write omega r by upper cutoff frequency minus lower cutoff frequency, or we can write square root of upper cutoff frequency into lower cutoff frequency minus like this, or we can write like this. So, we have so many formulas. So, quality factor is inversely proportional to what? Bandwidth. So, these are the main relations. Relation between quality factor and bandwidth is completed, and this one is also completed. Then we have some note point, that is selectivity, which is equals to
same as quality factor, which is equals to, you can write here, you can write FR by FH minus FL, okay. You can write here, these are nothing but with respect to radians per second, or you can write FR in terms of heads, FR by FH minus FL, like that you can write, okay. Which is equals to, here I am providing FR by FH minus FL, selectivity, which is same as quality factor, and dissipation factor, which is equals to reciprocal of quality factor. These two are some formulas, okay. See, from this, what is the observation? Quality factor is inversely proportional to what? Bandwidth, right? Quality factor is inversely proportional to the bandwidth. Observations. For example, I have omega, 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 this is the value of current, okay. Or we can have like this, okay. These are the responses or frequency response curves with respect to frequency, current versus frequency, okay. Then let us say this is the, for this curve the quality factor is, for example, Q1, and the bandwidth is nothing but PW1, like that. For this Q2, like this, Q3, then tell me which one is having more bandwidth and which one is having more quality factor. So here we are providing the range, not range, order of quality factor, like that we can provide order of bandwidth. So, which one is having more quality factor among these three, Q1 or Q2 or Q3? Q1 more than Q2, more than Q3, right? This is the order. Like that, what is the more bandwidth curve, that is curve 1 or curve 2 or curve 3? From this we can have quality factor and bandwidth are inversely proportional with each other. Therefore, this is having, the first curve is having more quality factor, therefore it is having less bandwidth, it is having less bandwidth. Coming to this second curve, it is moderate with respect to quality factor as well as with respect to bandwidth, okay. Coming to this last curve, it is having less quality factor, but coming to bandwidth, it is having more bandwidth. See, compared to this first curve, this is having more bandwidth. So, this is the very important observation from this analysis. So, we are having the bandwidth derivation, which is nothing but what? Upper cutoff frequency minus lower cutoff frequency, that is R by L in terms of radians per second, or heads, R by 2 pi L in terms of hedges. Like that, this is the relation between resonant frequency and half power frequency, that is square root of upper cutoff frequency and lower cutoff frequency, that is square root of geometrical mean of two half power frequencies. This is the relation between quality factor and bandwidth, that is inversely proportional to that bandwidth, and these are the observations. Those two are some formulas selectivity is nothing but what? Omega R by omega H minus omega L, like that. Dissipation factor is what? 1 by quality factor.